Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year to all my friends out there. Especially to a certain friend that sent me down a big box of beers. I don't mean that in a greedy way. Because there's certain friends that you make on the online and YouTube and online and YouTube and whatever, you know, and they're beer friends, you know. And beer friends to me, I've got friends that, you know, drink McLagers. I nearly said something else. I'm trying not to swear, you know. So I almost said shit, but I just about managed not to, you know. So, but you got beer friends that, you got friends that drink rubbish, and you know, they're cool. But you've also got beer friends that, unfortunately, live all around the place, all over the world and wherever. And they're great to know, and they're great, you know, and I've also got, like, Clash of Clans friends and things, which are also great, but, you know, they've got a completely different interest. And it's kind of never the twain shall meet, because I've had, like, beer friends have gone off, have been Clash of Clans, like, things and that, and I've been in my clan and that, and I've gone, I've got to kick this one, because he's a, you know, because it's not really fitting in and that, you know. And whatever else, you know, you get certain different ideas. But it's great to know people's ideas on beer. Beer, I think, for me, is the ultimate, international language, you know. And we all speak, you know, anyone that loves beer, we all speak beer, you know. So, 2 minutes in. From a very, very good friend, and a good beery friend. I've got two here. Ooh. That one contains lactose. Ooh, yum, yum, yum. Right, but I'm going to have the other one instead. So we've got two here, and one of them is this one. We've got they're both of Christmas ones, so Merry Christmas, ho ho ho, and this is we wish you a Merry Christmas, Kittymas I should say, and Christmas Kitty, Kitty, Christmas Kitty. It was the pink that threw me. I don't know. I don't think that I mean this at the women, but it's got a very lovely and funny, strange writing there. It's Brass Castle. And should I turn this upside down? Don't matter, does it? Because the yeast, I'd like the yeast in, right? And it is a dark beer. So I'm going to show you that. Look, Brass Castle. You see it? Brass Castle. If I just turn it upside down. You see that Brass Castle? Yeah, look at that. Look. Isn't it clever, isn't it? It's all gone a bit Dan Brown, isn't it? Right. Here we are, over here. Crash, bang, wallop. Oh. Hardly got a taste, it just about stopped on my lip. Right, here we go. Oh, beautiful. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Sorry, let's pour it up. All the lots going in, because I've already twisted it. And we've got a little one. A little 330. 5.5 on the old Richters. What I should have done is poured it out if I was going to... you know, I would have been pouring a lot in anyway, wouldn't I? It's beautiful. It's dark. It's dark. Actually, God Lord. It is black, virtually black. It's a browny burgundy right at the bottom corner, like bottom right down here, held up to a really bright light. It's dark. Right. Twist it, sniff, twirl it, smirl it. Right, spin it, stick your face in it. Oh, that's proper. Right, that is big. It's lovely and big. Malts are the star of the show. I love malts when they're star of the show. I also love hops star of the show, but I think I'm a malty man. You know, naughty malty. Oh, chocolate, coffee, chocolate, coffee. God, that is lovely. That is about it. That's, you know, pretty much the end of the smells. Nice little earthy, dusty notes on the coffee. Nice little pungent, little sweet notes on the chocolate. Both combined to just balance each other up. I think it's going to have a coffee finish. Tiny little sherbety notes in there and something sharp on the... I don't know if it's a zesty finish or something piney maybe. Something resiny. But the hops are struggling, you know. On the nose, anyway. So let's have a little taste. Still swirling, because when you taste with your nose and your mouth. So, remember? Don't breathe in like that as you're tipping, you know, so. Got it, right. And then as you breathe out, oh Jesus Christ, sometimes a beer shocks you, poof, like that, and then your brain goes like that, mine does, because I ain't got much of it left, but it goes like that, and then you go, what, where was I, what was, what, oh, what, it's like trying to read a book when you're on a roller coaster or something. Well, I'm going to have to do it again. I often have to do that. Because it goes, whoa, what? All right. And you have to go, okay, start the computer up again. Reboot. Ding, dong, dong, dong. Windows 94, whatever, 95. All right, let's give it a twist. Right, as I breathed out, got gulp, 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 it was lovely, 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 building, as I breathed out, big chocolate rush, milk chocolate notes coming in, big Cadbury's chocolatey notes, like the hot chocolate you get in McDonald's, sometimes they don't stir it properly and leave the splodge in the bottom, and you smell that. Afterwards, well, you know, you can finger it out, right? But you can, but you have a little smell at the, of course, strong, isn't it? And strong, chocolatey, milk chocolate, McDonald's kind of chocolate. I don't mean that in a nasty way, because, you know, it's quite nice, you know. But that going on? Then you got coming in, little squirts, like a little syringe. Imagine a syringe going and squirting little bits of like espresso on your tongue. But in tiny little sprays. This is a very good kind of way of showing the breathing and beer and the nose and the olfactory system and everything else is very important to actually tasting the beer, because you won't properly taste this beer unless you taste and let the nose gather it as well. So if you taste it in your mouth why you got a bit in your mouth, breathe out through your nose, you will really suddenly taste it on your mouth. When you're holding it, there's not a lot's happening. It's there, but it's, you know, it's gathering. On it. Then you go, oh, I can really taste it. And that's when you, sometimes people go, I can't taste anything. Because they go, gulp, gulp, gulp. And then they go, then, it's all gone. You've drunk it all, you know. Get a little bit and it work round. Because it comes up the back here as well. Right, that, is it all gone? Isn't it? That is unfortunately all gone. Very much a Christmas beer. Very, very much a Christmas beer. It's beautiful. It's a robust dark porter enhanced with vanilla and Christmas spices. I haven't got any Christmas spices with that. Got the vanilla. Mildly got the hops. I haven't got any Christmas spices. And they would be things like cloves and things like that, I would imagine. And star anise even and things, those sort of dark spices. Mulled wine sort of spices. I didn't get those, unfortunately. I didn't get the spices, but I did get massive lovely coffee notes and lovely chocolate notes. So... for beer that I don't think has got any chocolate in it, that there has worked very hard on the dark malts and the vanilla with it to make chocolate. That is lovely, really lovely. Bum 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 bum. Buy it, try it, love it. Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, my mate there, and. Behave yourselves, be good. And listen, it's Christmas. Love each other and be nice to each other. Don't matter what religion you are, don't matter what colour, creed and whatever you are. Because we're people, everyone's people with people. You know, please bear that in mind, you know, please do. People are people. And the fact that we don't understand each other and that, you know, I don't mean to get political and everything else, but it seems to me that certain powers that be have been reading Machiavelli and stuff like that, Machiavelli the Prince and that, and they've kind of have gone, that's a good way of controlling this and doing that. And they decide to control the populace by first separating everyone into groups. Fear the neighbours are coming over the wall. Oh, look, I'm not. Oh, they're eating one of our children and all that, you know, that sort of thing. No, they ain't eating one of your children. They've got their own children. They can eat their own. But you know what I mean? They're not eating cats. Not feeding your cats and that. And they're not eating your cats. They're not, whatever, every single stereotype, you know. The Chinese are eating their cats. Oh, and the, so-and-sos are bombing our cars and all that. The Irish are putting bombs under our cars and all that. Yeah, it might have been at some point, but in a very low amount, you know. Anyway, sorry, I've gone political. I really don't mean that. And I'm not a political animal. I really ain't, and I hate all that. All I mean to say is, look, it's Christmas. Love each other. And if it ain't Christmas, love each other. Respect each other. Say hello to people. And if you don't get an hello back, whatever, say hello. Say, smile, you know. You go up to someone in Tesco's or something, or wherever, you know. And they go, hello, like that. And you go, hello, like this, and you big smile. They go, oh, how's your day, you know, been all right? And dates, you know, your day today. And you go, all the better seeing you, like that. And you, and suddenly they're like, oh, you know. And you see them flutter. Not like because they fancy you or whatever, but it's just someone's flooded my day up and it, and their feathers are, bloop, 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 and it's lovely, you know. Just then the next customer gets their feathers all fluttery still, and they're hello like that. And this that hello has passed on, and the next customer goes, oh hello, oh you know, oh, thank you. What in it? Isn't it lovely in Tesco's, you know, get service with a smile. Whereas if you'd just had a go and should have been next person, right, you know. And even if they go to you, hello, right there, go, hello, and then smile on the way, you know. And it just makes your day better because their day picks up. Everyone you meet picks up. And that picks you up, you know. And, you know, there you go. I've spent 10 minutes talking about that. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Buy it or else. It's lovely. It's gorgeous. Thank you very much, my mate there. And fantastic stuff. Thank you for sending them down. See you in the next one. Don't be late.